fuck you, you black god motherfucker. I tell your ass shit.
You will tell me which of the Dark Forces games is being played in VR. Because there's so many ways they numerize the series. So many remakes. I can't get my head around it.
No, forget it, motherfucker. I ain't telling your ass shit.
Oh, if that's how it's gonna be, I'm gonna have to use the Kylo Ren trick of getting inside your head.
Kylo who?
It's from the sequel series. Nobody likes it. Anyway. Here I go, motherfucker.
Take my puppy dogs. Take my anything. Oh, goddamn. Ah, shit.
VRified games. So, these YouTubers / enthusiasts know all the details on what games to get from the Dark Forces series in VR. Well, isn't that something? I guess I don't need your gangster ass anymore.
Is that right, motherfucker? Zoom, zoom, motherfucker, let's go!
Oh, shit! Zoom, zoom, zoom! Dow!
Oh, shit. Force chokehold. Oh, fucking... Nah. Man, come on, we can talk about this. Don't have to cut my head off, man. Come on, I'm sick of just being a head. Oh, mother...
I want you to remember, son, when you're at the academy, how very proud I am of you. What a fine young man you've become. I wish your mother were here to see it. But I know she watches over you and is proud. After she died, your welfare and upbringing were the only thing I truly cared about.
Touching. When someone desires information, they come to me.
Don't waste my time, 88. Tell me who killed my father.
Patience. He is a dark Jedi.
Jedi?
Dark Jedi. He is known as Jerrik, and he has great plans for the rebirth of the Empire.
I'm not interested in petty political struggles.
Well, you should be. Without going into too much detail, Jerrik has been quite generous in his offerings. Unfortunately, you don't factor into them. But I am not without a heart. Familiar, yes? I found it in your dead father's home. I can decipher any language or code known, but this one eludes me. It must be important. Tell me what it is, and these gentlemen won't have to indulge their darker side.
The dark side? I've been there. Do your worst.
Well, I suppose that concludes our business.
Master the shelf. There's a dust floor.
I'm not interested in leaving. I have some business to conclude with your friend, 88.
What's up, player? Yeah, the living dead talking head. Coming to you live with Daigo in Glorified Games. How are we doing, Daigo?
Hello, Ed. How's it going?
Shit, I'm all right, homie. So, what we all play today, man?
Well, Ed, we've gone down a different rabbit hole today, I guess you could say.
Are we hunting rabbits?
Nope. No rabbits. Yeah, so the rabbit hole I'm referring to is the Dark Forces series.
Oh, yeah, I remember that when we did the Jedi Outcast VR, all the confusing shit.
Yeah. Well, even more confusing is there are a number of fan remakes for various titles within the series in production right now.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So, as you know, the mainline series consists of Dark Forces. Then they moved on to Dark Forces 2, Jedi Knight. Then they dropped the Dark Forces title and moved on to Jedi Knight 2, Jedi Outcast. Then they dropped the numeral title and they moved on to Jedi Knight, Jedi Academy.
Oh, man.
Yep. Yeah. Very confusing. And there was also an expansion pack for...
Get out of my bar. You always cause trouble.
Dark Forces 2, Jedi Knight, called Mysteries of the Sith. So, you know, you throw that into the mix, it gets very, very confusing also.
Oh, man, come on, man. You're making my head all higgledy-piggledy.
I'm sorry, Ed.
Oh.
Yeah, there's actually a made-for-VR remake of the original Dark Forces in production. There is an Unreal Engine remake of Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. There are VR ports for Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast and Jedi Knight Jedi Academy. In various stages of completion by Dr. Beef on standalone and by Shiny Quagsire on PCVR. So there are a number of titles out there, all floating around, all that you can get in VR.
Alright.
Yeah, so we're going to look at one of the lesser known ones, which is the remake for Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. A couple of reasons behind that. First being, when we're going all nostalgic like we normally do.
Oh yeah, it wouldn't be one of our videos if we didn't, I guess.
Yeah. This was actually the first game I've ever owned on PC, Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. First game I ever owned on PC. It's also the first game I owned that needed a graphics card, and the first time my dad almost had a heart attack when he realized how much that was going to cost. But it's neither here nor there. Yeah, so I've got tons of nostalgia for this. The remake itself, by Reportal, is made in Unreal Engine 4. Now, it is a very, very faithful remake of the original Dark Forces 2 in terms of the map. Identical, enemy placement identical. How it plays, how it feels, all of that. Feels like if you know the original Dark Forces 2 game, you'll be right at home here. It's identical. Even down as far as the secrets, everything in the maps, they're in the same location. Yeah, so. It's a nice trip down memory lane, and the second chief most important reason why we're looking at it is it was, as I've already said, developed in Unreal Engine 4. Now, why is that important?
Well, because Unreal, you can get it in VR, right?
Yeah, there actually is a VR runtime in the game. However, it's, you know, it's like most titles when they have VR implementation that hasn't been implemented properly, it's half-baked. So although you can load in, you can't get past the initial screen as you need to scroll the mouse down to click accept. So. You can't actually play the game. Now, those in the VR community are no doubt aware that there is a saving grace on the horizon. It's coming very, very shortly, and that is Praedog's Unreal Injector mod. I don't think it has an official name yet, but it's basically a VR injector that will get most, if not all, Unreal 4, Unreal 5, and even some Unreal 3 games into VR. Now, this is not what Vorpex does. This is basically putting a VR camera in the game, so it will feel native VR. Now that's on the horizon, it's coming, so there are a lot of titles that are just going to work out the box with this, and I cannot wait to try it out. But as it's not released as of yet, there are other ways of getting it into VR. The one I normally use that is...
Vorpex, motherfucker!
That's right, Ed, Vorpex. Now, I love Vorpex, love it to death. There are so many titles, so many experiences that I could never have had in VR without Vorpex, so I am forever grateful for that. But once Prey Dogs mod comes out, and you have an Unreal title, obviously Prey Dogs mod is most likely going to be King of the Roost. That's going to be the way to play these games, unless they have native VR. But as that's not out yet, we're booting it up in the Vorpex, kind of getting a feel of how this game would be in VR. Now, this is a huge nostalgia trip for me. Yeah, as I said before in one of my videos, there was rumblings of commercial VR in the early 90s. People were dreaming, people were speculating. I was one such dreamer, one such speculator. And yeah, this is one of the titles I could have seen myself playing in VR because it had a first and a third person perspective, but the first person perspective really caught me. I was like, oh man, I can totally imagine playing this in VR. Especially because around the same time, Quake was bundled with a VR headset on PC VR, so I know that first person perspective games could have been played in VR. Now, I hadn't experienced it. I had only experienced VR in arcades at that time. But I knew it was possible. It was only a matter of time. Did I know it would take nigh on 30 years? No, but, you know, here we are today. And I'm finally in the shoes of Kyle Katarn. I'm playing Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight in VR. There are many people out there who say Vorpex is not real VR, and I say thee nay. Although yes, it's not native VR, although yes, the games were not built for VR, how else would you experience such titles in VR without Vorpex, I ask you? Like, it comes pretty damn close. It's a proximity of VR, yes. But come on, you guys. Credit where it's due. Would you be able to experience Bioshock without it? Would you be able to experience, say, Borderlands, Fallout 3, all the Source Engine games, Black Mesa, you name it. There are so many titles out there that without Vorpex could not be experienced in VR. Now sure, there are other players out there like Superdead 3D, which is fantastic. There's Geo11, which is still, I would say, in its infancy, but it's coming along very, very well. But at the moment, Vorpex is there. Vorpex is king when it comes to running older titles in VR. It's struggling a lot with newer titles, that is true, but luckily we've got the Prey Dog mod to look forward to when that releases.
Okay, man, geez, you're rambling, man.
Okay. So yeah, Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight. Okay, so this is what would probably be referred to as a tentpole title for Lucasfilm. FPS games and third-person perspective games were still very much in their infancy back in 1995. So there was a lot of experimentation back then. Dark Forces 2. Even though it was relying heavily on experimentation, engine, it's actually surprisingly very cohesive, because other games from that time period, when they came to experimentation and seeing what worked and what didn't, tend to be kind of a mess when you look back at them now, like in terms of how they played. Not so much the Dark Forces series. Yeah, it plays very, very well. Everything is tight. Now sure, it's still a product of its time where, you know, enemy AI is not the greatest and physics is kind of out the window, but for the time, yeah, it was a great time. And this Unreal Engine 4 remake perfectly captures that. All the jank is there, but all of the charm that was originally there, originally present in 1995, is still present and correct now. Oh man, it's so much fun. It's so much fun. It's a long time since I played the game, but instantly all the secrets came back. You know, as I'm wandering the levels, I'm like, oh, there's a gun hidden behind here, or oh, there's a secret wall behind here. And I go to check it out, and yeah, it's a remake. You kind of expect, okay, it's not going to be there. It's there, and it's faithful, and yeah, love it.
Okay, man, so what's Dark Forces 2 Jedi Knight all about then?
Okay, well, it picks up after Dark Forces 1, obviously. You're playing mercenary Kyle Katarn, who doesn't really have allegiance to either side in the conflict. Kind of stays out of it for the most part. Yes, in Dark Forces, the original game, he was a spy working for the Rebel Alliance, but that was because they paid him. You know, he's the absolute definition of a mercenary. Had the Empire paid him more, he would work for them. So, this game picks up. His father has died, and there is Dark Jedi out there. Yeah! And they're trying to rebuild the Empire, so this takes place after Return of the Jedi, whereas Dark Forces took place during the original trilogy. So this Kyle Katarn is a little bit older, a little bit more grizzled. A little bit more jaded, I would say. The game is really cool because it features FMV, or full motion video, for the younger audience out there, which is kind of novel at the time, because CD-ROM was able to do that. So it was kind of cool. It was like having your own little new Star Wars movie. Every time there was a cutscene, you're like, oh my god, it's Star Wars, it's back. Again, it's kind of quaint now to look at it, but back then, if you were a Star Wars fan, that was kind of a big deal, because this is a few years before the special editions were coming out, back in 1997 for the 20-year anniversary. So although everybody in the Star Wars community knew they were coming, they weren't there yet, so this was your new Star Wars content. And there was also Shadows of the Empire as well, but that's for another video. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. So yeah, I got a little sidetracked there. So yeah, Jarek is the Dark Jedi. He's trying to re-establish the Empire's dominance in the galaxy. So... he's looking for this mythical place known as the Valley of the Jedi. Now, there was a Jedi Master called Ran, who Jarek captured and tried to interrogate, and although Ran did not give up the location, Jarek was able to find out that Morgan Katarn, Kyle Katarn's father, knew the location of the Valley of the Jedi. So that's where the story kind of picks up now, where Kyle is kind of dropped into the situation where he's like, okay, he's got to find the Valley of the Jedi. It's more personal now because it has something to do with his father. And Kyle kind of discovers along the way that he has latent Jedi ability. So this game is all about discovering that you're a Jedi, kind of learning the ropes, so to speak. It's yeah, it's a fun time. It's a good story. It's a nice adventure in the Star Wars universe. The remake we're looking at today only has two levels so far, which is the first introductory level, which everyone and their sister should know if they've ever played Dark Forces 2. And there is a battle with one of the Dark Jedi Yun that you can play. There is also a sandbox mode and a survival mode included. So it's coming along. It's a really cool project. Link in the description if you guys want to check it out for yourselves. Obviously it's meant to be played flat, but we got it in VR because that's how we do things over here. We are. VR-ified games after all, not pancake-ified games. Isn't that right, Ed?
Yeah. It's a pancake. I'm hungry, man. Get me the maple syrup and some bacon.
No, there's no pancakes. Jesus wept. Anyway, okay, we're going to leave it there, guys. Like, comment, subscribe. If you have any thoughts, queries, anything like that, put them in the comments below. We'll get back to you. If there are indeed any games you'd like us to VRify or take a look at. Leave it in the comments. We'll get back to you as soon as we can. Yeah, VRify games out.
Yeah. VRify games out of pancakes, out of maple syrup, out of bacon. Man, what am I supposed to eat up in here? You got nothing in that fridge because you a fat motherfucker. I'm wasting away, man. Look at me. I'm just a head.
Mind your own business. I know nothing.